Today we gonna make the second leg of Cuban Puerto Rican cooking. We're gonna do some Cubano sandwiches, which is basically ham, roast pork, pickles, mayonnaise, and Swiss cheese. And I got some good smoked Swiss cheese. You have to have some kind of sandwich press. Okay, this is mine. You can do it using two skillets. Cast iron skillets on the stovetop, getting them both hot, and pressing that bread. I don't have any Cubano bread as a special name, but I do have some French bread here that we're going to use. Basically, Cuban bread has got a crusty top. French bread that we have, they got it in soft crust and hard crust. This is soft crust. Mr. Sandwich Press is going to make it into hard crust. We're also going to do some, I better go get my facts straight. It's basically mashed potatoes with carrot in it, garlic, onions, and some kind of cream, either sour cream or milk, whatever you got. We'll also do some string beans that have lime, onions, I don't remember. It got a bunch of stuff in it. So we're going to get all that going, all right? Okie dokie, boy, we got some bacon browned down in this skillet. Done in the oven. And I'm going to put some of that grease down in this pan. All right? And we're going to put some green onions in there that I got already chopped up like that there. That's for them green beans, them Cuban green beans. All right, we're going to get them sauteing down. Come on, boy. Back in that other pot, we got a carrot and potatoes. We're going to have to peel them after they get tender. And that's going to be our Cuban mashed potatoes. And I'm going to make them kind of JB style. Now, what I learned about Cuban and Puerto Rican cooking pretty fast now is they use a lot of garlic. And I like that. So that was about 3 whole toes of garlic smashed up. They also use a lot of dry white wine. And they use a sweet vinegar. So I got some apple cider vinegar. Then I'm going to go look over there, boy. I'm going to go ahead and pour that in there and finish those vegetables sauteing down. And we're going to reduce this. And we're going to make the green beans and the mashed potatoes with this mixture. Now I got some fresh string beans right here. I'm going to go ahead and put them on the burner. So I can figure out which knob turns him on. We're going to put a little salt in there. And we're going to put a little pepper. Burl them for about 5 minutes, just until they tender. All right, now the directions say put a little butter in there, a whole lot of butter, as a matter of fact, and put them peeled potatoes and them carrots in there, and run it through a ricer. Well, I ain't got no goddamn ricer. I got this, so we're gonna rice them with this. Now we also got to put some other stuff in here. Heavy cream or sour cream. It's going to be my choice right off the damn bat. With some of this mixture of the garlic, and onions. So let me get all this whooped up. I'm thinking some cheese would go well in this. Sour cream. Salad cream, whatever you want to call it. And be sure and lick the damn. Knife. Right? Yum, that was good. Now, we got Cuban mashed potatoes. Yeah, we need some salt. That was pepper. And salt. We gotta mix all that up too. It gotta taste good. Oh yeah. We're tasting pretty damn good. Now here's them string beans. And they go in the pot with the rest of the garlic. Go on over there, boy. The onions and the other good stuff. So we're gonna give them a little saute. See, these are still slightly crisp. Cooked al dente, boy.